How's everybody doing? It's a beautiful crowd, man. I love big crowds. Just to get something off my chest before I even start. Everything I say up here tonight is a joke, okay? It is nothing else. I don't want nobody taking none of this stuff too serious. I mean, nobody coming up to me after the show talking about who's the funny one now. All that type stuff there, ready to fight and stuff like that. Look, I'm a bitch and I will let it be known, all right? You're on the same page, man. I don't like to fight. I've been robbed a lot. I'm traumatized because a lot of stuff has happened in the past. On top of all that, I don't need y'all stuff. And you know, it's at a point now where it's mental. I get scared real fast. Matter of fact, ask this group right here, don't y'all be making no sudden movements and nothing like that. Matter of fact, put your hands on the table so I know what you're doing at all times. So I'm gonna close my show. That's my time. My name is Kevin. I will walk right off. It'll be different, man. I'm serious. It would be different if I was getting robbed by big people, you know? People that should be robbing people. You know, like, you're a big guy. You rob me, I'm gonna have to accept it. You know what? You're bigger, take it. I would let it go. But it's not going down like that, you know? I'm getting robbed by women. Groups of kids running up on me now. I got robbed by one real strong midget. He didn't even have a gun. He just kept headbutting me. He just kept on headbutting me. And I finally just fell. I was like, that's enough, Mr. Midget. And I fell. He started running. You know you're real scared if you call a midget mister. That's how you know. I was like, that's enough, you know. I think the worst time, though, when I got robbed by a cross-eyed man, that took the cake. Let me tell y'all why I'm mad that he robbed me. He got upset with me because I didn't know that he was robbing me, you know. He was cross-eyed. What the hell was I supposed to think? He just came out yelling, give it up! So you robbing me, baby. You talk to me. Stop playing with me and don't move. Give it up! I have not moved since I've been standing here. Tyrone, give it to him, because I think he's serious. I'm talking to you. I said, now you wait a minute, all right? I thought you was talking to him, okay? Now, if you're talking to me, you need to look at him when you're talking to me. I don't know if you're talking to me. I don't know how to figure this out. I was so scared, y'all, because I run a lot, you know? You don't realize I run a whole lot. That's usually how I get away. Did you know it is rules and regulations to get robbed? Did you know that? They say if me and you together, right, somebody run up on us to rob us, if I run from the situation, I'm a bitch. That's what I'm saying. Now, me personally, I don't agree with this, because there's been situations where I had to run on certain friends of mine. At this time, I'm going to have to say, the hell with them. You know why? Because they saw the gun just like I saw the gun. That means they chose to stay and take the gun. I chose to run and get the hell out of there. And for some reason, until this day, my girl does not understand why I ran. I was standing and just watching what was going on, what they was doing. That wasn't the case. It was by the time I got away, I remember that she had the key to the car. But when I turned around, they were still hitting her and stuff. So I was like, I'm going to wait till they finish. Ain't no sense in both of us getting our asses whipped, you know? That would be real selfish of her, wouldn't it? Somebody had to drive home. That's how I look at it. Somebody had to get us home. That's all I had to say. People don't realize, you know, females, y'all just don't realize, man, people are too crazy to be fighting everybody, man. People are losing their minds now to be fighting everybody. And I'm sorry, I'm not a hostile person. I'm friendly, and I'll admit it. I don't like to fight. I'm a friend. I'm your friend, all right? Don't you take nothing out on me. It's me. You know where I was when I saw some of the craziest people I've seen in the world? I was on the train. I swear, y'all, I've never seen as many crazy people in my life. Have you ever sat next to somebody on the train that sleep for the whole train ride, but when they stop, come up, they just pop the hell up and get up and walk them off the train? Don't nobody touch them or nothing. And you be sitting next to them, you're like, who touched them? I can't believe this, he got right up. Old people, they really get me mad, because they get upset with you when you don't want to give up your seat, you know? No, the hell with you. I'm tired too. When you see them, do what I do, act like you sleep. Look at this.
I can't believe this. She coming back. She coming back. Go back to sleep.
Don't give up your seat. I don't. But you know who I love? I like that pervert guy that stands like this in the center. And then when the bus get real crowded or something, that's when he got to grind on everybody's butt to get to the back. Excuse me, baby, watch out. Let me get to the back. Stay right there, sis. I'm just trying to get to the back.
Don't move. Watch out. I'm just trying to get right here. Stay right there. I'm almost there, baby. Don't move. I can't believe they sat you up front. Oh, goodness.
He is a professional grinder. Be careful. He does that for a living, man. And you know, they're not the only people that's crazy. Me, myself, I think dirty people might be some of the craziest people out there, too. Because you have to be some kind of crazy, a mental person, just to decide at some point in your life to be dirty, you know. That's a crazy decision, you know. How does something like that go down? Would you just wake up one morning mad? I ain't washing my ass no more. And then you go back to sleep, you know. That's it. Because that's not something that you can just forget to do. You know, you can't keep saying, I forgot to wash my ass again. That's good for the first couple days, but 3 weeks later, you're still saying the same thing to your friends. They're going to start to question you. That's been going on for 3 weeks. Everybody wants a tattoo now. You know, everybody needs a tattoo. I have no problem with tattoos. I feel that if you're going to get a tattoo, get something that you know what it says. Everybody wants a Chinese tattoo now. For what? You don't know what it really says. You walking around thinking you got black power or something on your head. Turn out you going to a Chinese store, you got salt, pepper, ketchup written across your face. And you don't know the home start laughing. Look at this, all salt, all pepper, ketchup right there. Oh, no, this ain't black power. No, no trouble, no trouble. Salt, pepper, ketchup. Be careful. Do things that we know what we're doing, man. Stop going crazy stuff. You know what's funny in the gym, though? Y'all see those people in the gym that are too strong? Y'all see somebody in the gym that's too strong? Got too many muscles, you know? I saw this one guy in the gym. He had too many muscles. I had to tell him. I said, that's enough. God damn, don't you lift nothing else? Where you gonna put that muscle? And he talking about something. No, I got this soft spot behind my ear. Do me a favor, put 345 pounds on the back of my neck so I can go ahead and lift that up. And I went to go get it, and I looked at him in the face. That was the midget that had robbed me. Hey, y'all been a great call. My name is Kevin Hart. Enjoy the rest of your show.